Hey guys, welcome to episode 11 of Nightclub Photography TV. I'm your host, Myles. For those of you who have never tuned in to Nightclub Photography TV, we cover anything and everything about nightlife and nightclub photography. And these episodes are very informal. We pick a topic and we discuss it just like we're next to each other at a bar, at a club, and we ask straightforward questions, get straightforward answers. Anyway, in episode 11, what we wanted to cover for this episode is something more general, a general topic, and we kind of refer to it when we're covering the topics in the previous episode and correct exposure and how to determine your correct exposure. And moving forward from that, we want to move into how to really dictate your own personal style. So correct exposure and personal style. Now, in episode 10, we mentioned how to work with the different aspects or factors in nightclub photography, shutter, ISO, aperture, FEC, and how that will determine your final exposure, your correct exposure. But the first thing is you need to determine what that baseline combination of settings should be, and that is going to be based on what you define as your correct exposure. So what is your correct exposure? You guys have to figure it out for yourself, and that is all going to be dependent on your photographic style, your own, the way you want to approach your photos, what you think is the ideal nightclub photo. And because you're the photographer, you dictate that. Of course, others will have their own opinions, and you may be led to believe that their opinions are the best or the norm. That's really up to you. But I wanted to discuss really establishing your own personal style, simply because there are a lot of nightclub photographers who go out there and just shoot anything and everything, and they don't really have a style. And so you really can't tell that the photos you're looking at are their photos. And also, they don't really delve deeply into one specific type of style. And so their photos, they can never really excel very well. It's kind of like this. Think of it this way. If you are building a house, you have to have a plan. You have to have a vision. And that's the only time you're going to be able to build or construct a really great house, a home. Same thing with photography. If you don't have a goal in mind or a certain style, well, your photos are not going to really be very good. So main thing is you need to have a personal style and stick with it. Of course, when you're first starting out, you're trying to define that style. But I know a lot of people who have been doing nightclub photography for years, and they don't have a style. They don't have a style at all, and so they'll never excel. And also, they find themselves involved in so many different aspects of photography: studio, wedding, fashion, pet photography, you name it, and they're trying to do it. Well, they're not going to grow. They're not going to grow. You have to pick something specific. For instance, if you're a doctor and you're trying to be an accountant, you're trying to be a lawyer, are you going to go anywhere? No, you probably will know only the Cliff Notes version of anything. So with nightclub photography, develop a personal style. And what I wanted to do today is really just cover some four major areas that will dictate the type of personal style or the type of photos you take in nightclubs and bars and events. And the first type is where you have dark backgrounds, okay? As you can see on your screen right now, here, this photo is a nightclub photo taken at a bar, club, and the background is dark. There's not a lot of ambient lighting. And the person taking this photo could be doing this on purpose. This could be their photographic style, their personal style. They want to not capture the ambient light, but really focus lighting on the subject. So that's one particular style. You may want to do that. If you see some photos like that on the net or different magazines, that doesn't mean they're wrong. It's just that photographer's personal style. On the flip side, take a look at this photo. Here, the photo captures the ambient lighting, where this is normally the type of photo nightclub photographers want to take. It captures the ambient lighting, and it balances the lighting with the subject. And this is the type of style that I like too. I like to get ambient lighting. I like to balance it out with my subjects. And to go a little bit further, I want my lighting on my subjects to be very balanced and as soft as possible. On the flip side, there are other people who want it to be very bright. The skin has to be very bright. So you already have seen there are two types of personal styles there. One where you have dark background, one where you capture the ambient lighting. Which one is right? It's up to your personal style. But even beyond that, there are other two major areas that people differ in their approach to nightlife photography. Take a look at this photo. As you can see in this photo, there are not a lot of shadows. A lot of people in fashion photography don't like a lot of shadows. They want to evenly light up their subjects. And they normally use it through a ring flash. But for nightlife photography, I think a ring flash is overkill and you don't need it. But in any case, there are no shadows. And a typical flash photo can do this also. A pop-up flash can do this also in terms of getting rid of the shadows and even lighting on your subject. And if you want that style, then you can do it. You can, you know, you can use, set up your camera in a way or your flash system in a way where there are little shadows, okay? Now, your pop-up flash is going to be completely different from a ring flash. Ring flash, you have a reverse halo effect, and it's much more even, and it's much more flattering. So don't compare an on-camera flash with a ring flash. They're two different animals. In any case, so you see, that's one particular style, how to use your flash and how to light up your subjects, where there are not a lot of shadows. You're getting rid of the shadows. Another train of thought or another style is to capture the shadows. Like in portrait photography, adding shadows adds that three-dimensional feel. It helps your subjects pop out a little more. In contrast to getting rid of the shadows, like fashion photography, it's a little different. So which one do you use? It's up to your personal style. Take a look at this photo. This captures the shadows. This uses off-camera flash, and the shadows are created on purpose. And it's because of a personal style. This is the style that I like too. I like to have a three-dimensional style where I'm capturing the shadows. Okay? So those are four main areas that will dictate your personal style and, as a result, your correct exposure. What do you want to, what combinations of settings do you use to achieve that personal style? Okay? Now, of course, you can use different types of combinations. You could have a dark background where you don't capture the ambient lighting, and maybe you want to capture shadows with your subject lighting, or maybe you want dark backgrounds and no shadows on your subject, or vice versa. Maybe you want to capture the ambient lighting with shadows on your subject, or ambient lighting without shadows. So those are just main four main personal styles, but personal style goes even further. It can be in terms of types of photos you take. Maybe you're really a DJ-oriented person, or you like to take pictures of the dancers. So it all depends. But the main purpose of this episode is really to instill the idea that, guys, go out there and pick a personal way of shooting, okay? Pick up a personal style. If you don't have one yet, develop one and shoot with the goal of attaining one, okay? You don't want to just go out there and build a house without a plan, all right, so to speak. Okay, so make sure you go out there, experiment, and then once you have that personal style, you'll know what the correct exposure is, and then you can go back to episode 10A and 10B and tweak things and always get the results that you want. All right, so that's it for episode 11. Want to make it a little light this episode, more general. And as always, guys, ask questions if you'd like, go on the forums. Those of you who want to leave messages through YouTube or on the forums and comments, just bear with us, because sometimes it takes a little bit of time to get back to all your messages, but we will get back to you. All right, guys, if you have any questions, suggestions on the forums, in the comments, feel free. Until next time, guys, I'm Myles. Keep shooting, and hope you enjoyed the episode. Take it easy.